This episode of The Young Turks is brought to you by Thrillist. The Federal Trade Commission has just released new guidelines on how advertisers should create advertisements for children, okay? And they're specifically targeting food companies. They're having issues with the way that, let's say, cereal makers or food companies are using, like, cute, cuddly-looking cartoons to sell specific foods to children, especially when those foods aren't good for them, when they're high in sugars, fats, right. And don't have important nutritional elements like whole grains. So the Trade Commission is saying, look, either you stop selling your foods using these cartoon characters, or you make these foods healthy, and then you can use the cartoon characters to sell the foods to children.
Right.
Now, the thing that's funny about this is these guidelines are not mandatory, they're just suggestions.
Right.
So,
okay, thanks. We'll take a look at that.
Yeah.
We'll go with the John Boehner. We'll take a look at that.
Yeah. The guidelines are meant to be voluntary, but companies are likely to face heavy pressure to adopt them. I'm sure that the heavy pressure will really, you know, work. It'll make them cave.
It's stupid. What are they going to put Captain Crunch out of business? What's he going to do?
Yeah.
He's going to just start making him like a Nazi Captain Crunch, you know? Like, he's not a cute, cuddly captain. He's like a really hardworking, slave-driving captain of a ship, and you don't want to eat a cereal anymore.
I'm not going to go there because this could get so much worse. I'm not going to.
No, well, I want to hear. Take it one more step. One more step, JR. Come on.
I thought that's where you were going. Like, he's a slave driver of a ship,
yeah,
or something, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's because I said that.
We don't want to think about the images. No, I know you said slave.
Oh, you didn't know I said
no,
slave?
No, I didn't. I thought that's where you were going.
No.
Do you guys think it should be, enforced that they have to?
I'm split on that. What I'm more interested in doing is holding companies accountable for false advertising, because I think that happens all the time. Like, for instance, you'll have this massive bag of chips, right? It'll be, I don't know, I'm making it up. It's like Lay's or something. And it'll say, no trans fats. Or, you'll have cereals that are so sugary and so bad for you, and it'll say, made with whole grain. But in reality, they're terrible for you. And they use, a teaspoon of whole grain in the entire box, and somehow they try to fool you into thinking that it's healthy. That I want to regulate
so people
don't get the wrong idea. People are not, they're not as diligent as they should be when it comes to food. Like, no one's gonna read every label when they're shopping for food at the grocery store, right? So they look at the labels right in front of them, whatever's advertised right in front of them, and I think a lot of people tend to believe it. Like, oh, look, this box of cereal made with whole grains must be healthy. Let me put it in my shopping cart. That happens all the time.
But I think people, first of all, you're right. But I also think that the issue becomes, at a certain point, parents have to be responsible.
Mm-hmm.
So, look, you have a toucan selling you Fruit Loops and your kid is mesmerized by it. Well, yeah, okay, get the Fruit Loops. Don't just get Fruit Loops and don't, you have to, at a certain point, be a parent and speak up. I just think that that's silly, and because kids are going to eat sweet cereal once in a while.
Right.
You just have to sort of regulate when they eat it.
Anna, we have a new sponsor, Thrillist. They're very cool because they hook you up with really interesting things going on in your town or any town you might be in that you don't know about.
Right. They also let you know where the best restaurants, bars, venues are.
Thrillist.com/TYT.